Now that we are already familiar with how we can develop a small application, Hello World application though, using visualstudio.net, I would like to demonstrate in this particular video how we can develop a small application, same thing almost what we did earlier, but without using visualstudio.net, instead using command line compiler, which is CSC.EXE. So for this, first start Notepad and type the program. So we start with using system class static void main. In case we want, we can provide the command line argument. Let's say hello world, save it. We can save it anywhere, wherever we like. Let's say I save it again in same Windows samples folder by the name demo.cs. Now once I have the demo.cs file saved there, my next action is to compile. Obviously, Notepad we have only edited, we cannot compile it here. Now go to command prompt. And at command prompt type csc.exe. Csc.exe is not a recognized or internal or external command. Why? This csc.exe actually is in framework folder, and the framework folder is not specified in path. We do not have the complete framework folder in path. So what we have to do now is we have to first add the framework folder to the path. Now how can we do this? Where is the framework folder first? You will find it in C:\Windows\Microsoft.net, and here you see this is the framework folder actually. But we should further go to framework, and you see here there are different versions of the framework. We have framework version 1.0, 1.1, 2.0, 3.0, 3.5 and 4.0. We don't see 4.5. Obviously for the reason that all the files of the framework 4.5 are installed in the existing 4.0 folder itself. There is no new folder created for framework 4.5. So basically framework 4.5 merges with the existing version of framework which is there on the machine, that is framework 4.0. So be very clear, for framework 4.0 and 4.5 we have the same folder. Now go to this folder, and here you will find lot of files, lot of tools are there, lot of utilities are there. What is of our interest is csc.exe file. This is what is of our interest. Now this whole path, just select here, this whole thing we can select and go to command prompt and set it in path. How to change the path? Give path is equal to preserve the old path, just put percentage path semicolon, and then you have to paste what we have copied there. We have to paste. The best way to paste is go here, edit and paste. Now press enter. So this new path is now appended to the old path. See, this new path is now appended from here till here. Now type csc.exe. Fine. It's not giving error like before. It's not saying this command is not recognized. Command is recognized, but it needs some input and we haven't provided yet. So let's do that now. Now go to D:\Windows\Samples. And here type csc.exe. Space the file name demo.cs, and we have an error. What is the error? Semicolon is expected. I think I saved it. Save as demo.cs, replace it, just come back, rebuild. Save save as Windows samples. Something is going wrong. Let's delete demo.cs, come back, file, save, good. Oh, error is here, semicolon. Using system, semicolon, line 1. It's clearly mentioning actually. In demo.cs, line 1, there is an error. And put the semicolon here. Now run this. It will build and generate a .exe file. So we have now demo.cs and demo.exe. Now run demo.exe. Hello world. That's the output printed on the command window. Now, let's modify this. Let's say I want to now use command line argument. So I'll change it to plus args of 0. Save it. Come back here. Again, rebuild it. Every time you make a change to source code, you'll have to rebuild the project. You have to rebuild the file and then run. Now, if I run demo.exe, you will get an exception. Why? Index out of range exception. Command line argument is not provided. So let's provide command line argument demo, or let's say test. So it will print hello test. So like this, we are able to write in Notepad. We are able to go to command prompt, and using CSC.exe, we'll have to compile and generate exe, and that exe we have to execute. Instead, when we use studio, all these things are happening in background. When we use studio, this is the editor which studio provides. Studio in background uses CSC.exe as the console based application, passes to it the file name as command line argument, compiles it, whatever error it generates, like you have seen there was an error generated at the time of compilation here, studio will capture it and studio will display it on its own window. So basically studio is an IDE, integrated development environment, which makes things more easy for us. Rather in studio, immediately it would take a highlight here and tell you semicolon is missing. The editor is intelligent enough, the C# editor is intelligent enough to highlight wherever there is an error. Now, what I would suggest you here is, you should type this same program in Notepad, execute, and you'll see that, like I have made one small mistake, you might probably make many more mistakes. One point which I would like to you to surely notice is, C# is a case sensitive programming language. And every character case here is very important, especially the character M. M lowercase is not allowed. When you put M lowercase, this is not an entry point method main. Put this, save it, come to command prompt, compile it again, you'll get error. Why? There is no suitable entry point method main. It is looking for uppercase M, and this is the most common mistake people do, at least the beginners would do while writing the program. And here we are doing concatenation. So I would suggest you to take this as a small piece of code, type in Notepad, go to command prompt and execute, and this will give you pretty good confidence on your first application. That's all in this video. Thank you.